One second. Let me connect this FFC cable to the board. And turn on the power. All right, now it's working. The project I'm currently making is calendar. It'd be a good idea to post it somewhere like the refrigerator and share your family's schedule. As my family is growing, there are lots of things I shouldn't forget. Some events like school events or family events, something like that. So having a calendar like this would be very useful, since the device will be updated once a day or every 12 hours. The battery consumption will be very low. It's also very thin and light, so you can attach it and use it anywhere. It is very important to partially update the screen in e-paper display. Of course, depending on your project, you may not need this feature. This may not be particularly necessary if you need to re-render each page at once. However, as an application developer, I cannot implement the functions I want unless they are partially updated. If you are interested in the ePaper display project, you may know about a project called EPDiy. They put a lot of effort into updating the ePaper display quickly and it's working great. So what I wanted to do was I thought it would be fun to develop an application based on the hardware they made. So I purchased this PCB from them and I'm currently working on the project. One second, let me show you the controller board. This PCB supports most e-paper displays on the market. It also fully supports the 9.7-inch TC2 e-paper I'm using. Additionally, based on ESP32S3, you can do your own programming using Arduino or ESP IDF. Also, there is a port for connecting a battery, so you can easily connect and use a repo battery. This is a very well-made board, I think so. The advantage of the e-paper display is that it's clearly visible even under bright sunlight. There is no problem with readability at all, just like reading a newspaper outside. This was created for testing partial updates. The one above runs on ESP IDF and the one below runs based on Arduino framework. Can you see the speed difference? According to the EPDiy library, suboptimal cache configuration cannot be set in the Arduino IDE, which results in slow performance. This is why I highly recommend using ESP IDF if possible for projects that will use EPDiy. As you can see, there is a big difference in the speed of updating the screen. I plan that I will share my calendar project once it is completed. Alright, that's it for today. Thank you for watching. See you on the next project.